Governor Murphy hit the hustings this weekend. So did his wife, First Lady Tammy Murphy. Between the two of them, by tonight, they will have done 40 campaign stops over 4 days. Murphy says in a low turnout election like tomorrow's, where the assembly tops the ticket, you never know who's going to actually come out and vote.
A lot of my energy and my wife's and our colleagues' energy has been devoted at getting people fired up to get out there and vote tomorrow.
Are they fired up, we ask?
Listen, in the rooms and places I've been in, they feel fired up, I have to say. I was in Bridgewater yesterday. We had a room full of energy. Some of you were there. I was at the Westfield train station, fired up. Was at a big breakfast in Fairview in Bergen County yesterday, 600 or 700 people. So we'll see. That's why they play the game. This is the night before the game, and we're going to know a lot more tomorrow night than we know today.
4 districts are considered most in play, districts 1, 8, 21, and 25. The marquee race is in 21 in Union, Morris, and Somerset counties. That's where Republican Minority Leader John Bramnick and his running mate Nancy Munoz are being challenged by Democrats Lisa Mandelblatt and Stacey Gunderman. 2 conservative Republicans are also on the ballot as third-party independents and could siphon votes away from the moderate Republican incumbents. Bramnick said this weekend the Democrats didn't want Murphy in their district.
It's my opponents who won't take a picture with him, because they know in my district, which is a reasonably moderate district, that he's far to the left.
But here they all are at the Westfield train station yesterday with Congressman Tom Malinowski. The state Republican Party has called tomorrow's election the Murphy midterm and a referendum on his first 2 years. The governor said today he's okay with that.
It's certainly at least partly a referendum, and we welcome that because we like where we're headed. We inherited a mess. We said we would stand for a stronger and fairer New Jersey that works for everybody, that we would be for the middle class, the working families, the folks like I was growing up who looked up hoping someday to get into the middle class. And I think we have done what we said we would do, investing in education. By example of today, we will fix NJ Transit if it kills me, which it might. I hope not in this at this moment.
Monmouth University pollster Patrick Murray thinks Murphy is not a big factor in the election.
Phil Murphy probably neither helps nor hurts the cause at this point. There are other entities that are much more important right now in voters' minds. That includes the current president, Donald Trump, and also includes the former governor, Chris Christie. Even though we're a couple years removed from him as governor, he still has a significant impact on how the Republican brand is seen here in New Jersey.
Party control is not at stake. The Democrats currently enjoy a 54-26 majority. The wild card is the voters.
Tomorrow, just by the configuration of the ballot, is typically a low turnout election. So your vote always counts, but tomorrow counts even a little bit more.
Last week, there was some question whether the governor would campaign at all for Democratic candidates in tight races. That question has been answered. How much good it will have done remains to be seen. In Bridgewater, I'm Michael Aaron, NJTV News.